It's my pleasure to introduce some of the artists to you today. I think we should begin perhaps with Ardine Nelson, who is, why don't you come on up? And Ardine, you're a professor emerita at The Ohio State University. You taught there for many years. You've worked in many, many museums around the country. You've received numerous awards, including the very prestigious John Simon Guggenheim Fellowship Award. And I know from, we met maybe about a decade ago, in almost every jury show that takes place in Central Ohio, if our dean enters, the jurors from around the country select her photography as among the best. You can see it at the Columbus Museum of Art, you can see it at many other museums. There's a photograph here to my left, and three more photographs front of the stage. Our dean's going to talk about her inspiration, and her techniques, and explain to her some of the different bodies of the world that she's been loving.
Way over to the Lazarus building, and I kept going, I've got to get in there, I have to fill that out. Initially, the gates were down. After it totally closed, and there weren't any, what, no one was allowed into the block mountain here, some people used to go walking. Some of the gates were open, and I could actually get inside spaces. And that, these are the so this place, of course, was not going to be recycled the way on the floor. Another project I had worked on during this period of time is in Germany, mainly around Dresden, Germany. And it's about Schreiber gardens. Quickly, Dr. Schreiber in the 1860s in Leipzig, Germany, when industrialization people were coming, moving to the city and living in apartments, they were losing all of their fresh vegetables and being outside in the air a lot. He proposed that there should be set aside government land that could become gardens. So they're often they're called Schreiber gardens. The expansion of this, of course, is allotments in England. We have community gardens in the United States that are quite different. But the Schreiber gardens are large areas. There are over 350 associations in Dresden. It might be anywhere from, I think the smallest one I saw had 35 gardens within it. The larger one that I saw had over 350 individual gardens within the area. And they're in many places. Some are by railroad tracks, but others are by apartments, except for this particular one. This fence right here would be one edge. This gardener, see it up close, there's strawberries. I was back there several years later. This tree got quite a bit bigger. This side was flowers. The rules for Schreiber gardens are one third flowers, one third vegetables, one third grass. They don't all comply. But the garden associations told me that in general, they're approximately at that point. So the government doesn't get really upset about it. Anyway, the other one I brought shows a different area, a different garden area. These are apartments up here. And if you see this one up close, you can see that there's a lot of balconies with flowers on it. But they have paths that you can walk on because it's government land. The rules are that the pathways during the day, people have to be allowed to stroll through in the seniors, which is how I was able to be in there and make photographs. I only went into the garden area if the garden was there and they invited me to come in right there across that boundary. But this is one of the simple fences that's along the path here. The path's about 6-8 feet wide. Most of the gardens are areas that might be 40 or 50 feet by 100 plus feet. They're not small. They're allowed to have a structure on it. This is where they really push it. It's supposed to be one room. I saw a two-level garden houses. They wouldn't go around. Full kitchens, bathrooms, bedrooms, the whole thing. Many, many rooms. And you have to pay a fine of like €5 a year if they have more house space than they're supposed to have. They don't actually live there, but in the summertime, they stay there quite a bit. So you can see the garden house in this one, but all the apartments behind. And a lot of people, it was really an interesting project because a lot of the artists in Dresden, that community, thought that the people that lived in the gardens were all working class. The reality is, I found retired doctors and scientists, etc., and people that traveled all over the world, especially after the wall came down, and they could leave and go anywhere in the world. So it was a really interesting project because I felt like I brought information to the rest of the community about the gardeners and what the gardens are really about. they are often handed down generationally. So that someone, I was in one woman's garden who was telling me when she was 4 years old what happened in this train track, that sort of thing. So they are handed down, and it's really an interesting process. None of them all like what community gardens are like here. And so that kind of gives you an idea of where that piece is coming from, which is again about plant flows. In this case, getting in very close and looking at not the plant as, okay, here's a pretty flower, but what happens as it begins to fade and change. This one's actually a little more things like that. So it becomes rather abstract. And you have to really get close to it to see some of the detail. A couple other new ones are working on.
Well,
that is like similar. You know, I got the microphone. But you get really close to see the parts of how this is changing as the flower is growing into something. So that's kind of where